Hey, my friends, how are you today? Today I got a new video that I'm making for a Corporación Universitaria del Caribe for Electiva 2. My name is Danilo Salazar, and I'm making this video. We're going to talk about the exam, the test PTE and FCE. These two exams that are made by the Cambridge University. So let's get started. Let's check it out. The PTE is the Cambridge English B1 preliminary exam, previously known as the PET exam, which stands for Preliminary English Test. It's designed for a student with intermediate English, like all of the Cambridge English exams. The PET exam is a pass-fail test, and for those who pass, it delivers a certificate that does not expire. The B1 preliminary exam can be either a paper-based test or a computer-based test. In both versions, the PET lasts 40 minutes in total. Well, it says like 140 minutes, but I don't think it's so many minutes. I think it's 40 minutes. Well, I don't know. That's what it says over here. 140 minutes in total. Okay, so there is, okay, that is that you can do it on a paper or you can do it through the computer, and it's called preliminary English test for the B1 level, B1 preliminary test. So let's see what we got. I'm gonna give you some tips about this test, then I'm gonna give you another tips about the FCE. Let's check that tips. The tips for the PET. First, get familiar with what you are going to do. First of all, it says it is important that you know each part of the speaking exam. You will be asked questions individually by the examiner. That's going to be a person there, and he's going to ask you some questions. You will be given some images and will be asked to interact with your partner. You're going to have another partner, or another person next to you, or in the other computer, and you're gonna interact with that person. You will be given a color photograph, will need to be able to describe what you see. This is a general conversation based on a topic of the photograph. Talk about your likes, dislikes, preferences, experience, habits, etc. All right, so you're gonna have a person next to you that you and that person are gonna talk about the photograph that they're gonna show you. And you have to describe, you have to talk or tell the other person what you like, what you don't like, what are your preferences, et cetera, okay? Let's get for the second one. How to improve your PET speaking part. Very important over here. It says you will be asked questions about your past, present, and future. Make sure you answer in full sentences and not just a few words. What that means by this, full sentences, that means that if they ask you, where are you from, you don't gonna say USA. No. If they ask you, where are you from, you're gonna say, I'm from the United States and I live in New Jersey, the city of Piscataway. That's a full sentence right there. Don't say just few words. I live in the United States, I eat lunch. No. You have to be more full. The length of the sentence got to be more words on it. That's what I want to say. Okay, let's go for the third one. Says how to improve PET speaking part two. In this part of the test, you will have to interact with your partner to build a conversation together. You will need to discuss, make and respond suggestions, and come to an agreement at the end. That means you're gonna make a conversation with the partner. You're gonna discuss about that. You're gonna suggest answers and questions about the conversation, and you both have to agree on the conversation. Have to agree in the same thing, the same matter. Okay, let's go for the fourth one. The fourth one says how to improve PET speaking part three. In this part of the test, you will be asked to speak on your own about a picture for up to a minute. It's very important that you speak for as long as possible. And don't worry at all if the examiner interrupts you and asks you to stop. Okay? If he does that, that means that the length, the speaking that you are doing about the picture that they're going to show you, maybe it takes more than 1 minute. Or maybe he's going to stop you and ask you any other questions about the picture. So don't worry about that, okay? Let's go for the fifth one. It says, how to improve PET speaking part 4. In this last part of the test, you will need to talk to your partner again. That means you're going to have the same partner that you had before. You both will need to give opinions and talk about your likes, dislikes, preferences, experience, and habits. That means now that's going to be you two together right there, and you have to give opinions on what he likes. If he says, I like hamburger, then you're going to say, well, I don't like hamburger because this, that, you know. Then the same thing is going to happen to you. Maybe he's going to ask you what you don't like or what your preference or what habits do you have. Then you have to answer that. Try to answer that in a long way, in a long sentence, and not short ones, okay? Okay, very good, very good. Let's go for the FCE. This is the other test, okay? We saw the big one. This is for the B2. You know that's the scale, European scale. Okay, the first certificate exam. That's FCE, stands for the first certificate exam or FCE. It's a very popular general English exam for students who wish to obtain a qualification demonstrating an upper intermediate level of English. It is well recognized and accepted by many universities and businesses as a reliable English language test. It was also recently renamed by the Cambridge B2 First. If you wish to search for further information, you can go into the webpage of the Cambridge University and you can find more information about this test. That is a very nice test, a B2 level. B2 is the level where you can hold a conversation, okay, that you can answer and you can ask questions. So you can hold a conversation, you understand much of the English. Okay, very good. Let's see some tips. It's not too many on this one, but let's see some tips about it. The first one, learn what each writing requires to you. This is what you're going to have in the test. You're going to have to do an essay about any topics that they're going to give you. You're going to have to write a letter, a report, an article, and a review. You have to write that on a piece of paper or on your computer too, because this test is given to on paper or on review. You can find in the internet on the Cambridge University webpage, you can find there where are the locations where you can take these tests. Okay, let's go for the second one. It says, learn chunk of language. You say, what? Chunk of language? What is that? Okay, chunks are words that commonly go together, like, I look forward to meeting you. Kind regards, a convincing argument. So that chunk of words, you can learn a lot of words, a lot of vocabulary, and this way you're going to learn how to do this test, how to write it or put it there on paper. The third one is record your errors and rewrite your answer. This is a very good tip, because sometimes we don't know where we made the mistake, and it's good to record ourselves, especially when we are speaking. We have to record and listen again to us and see where the error was made. And when I'm writing, I make errors too. So I have to rewrite those errors, check the dictionary, check Google, check, I don't know, any other of these web pages that are going to help you for that. Number four, learn your synonyms. Learn your synonyms. It's not only one word that you have to learn. You have to learn other many words that means the same one as the main word that you just saw, like writing, like speaking, like listening, I don't know, like, you know, any other words anyway. You can learn those synonyms, okay? Number five is improve your writing with Grammarly app. You know that Grammarly app is a very good app, because Grammarly app is going to check your errors, okay? Your grammar is going to check where you put a comma and where you put a dot, and where you a hyphen, well, any all these things, it's gonna organize the way you speak, gonna organize all your letters, or it's gonna organize all the phrases or the sentences. It's gonna tell you what is wrong, what doesn't go here, what goes over here. It's gonna change to for a synonyms too. It's gonna change. So Grammarly is a very good app for you to learn how to write. The essay is good to write it in Grammarly. Grammarly, I love Grammarly. It's good. It's good. Okay, looks like this is the last part of these tips that I just gave you. There's not many differences between the two tests. Only that one is for B1, level B1. The other one of level B2. One of them have like three parts, like we saw over here, that speaking have like four parts, etc. And the other one have like five parts. But both of them, they're gonna test you in speaking, in writing, and listening, and in what's the other one? Speaking, writing, listening. I forgot the other one. Well, it's four of them. Let me check again. Speaking, listening, writing, and I forgot what's the other one that they test. But they test four of them, four of the languages. So, well, this is all for today for me. So I'm going to see you next time, the next video. Have a nice day, and I will see you. If you like this video, just click on the little bell right there on the bottom of the screen. Okay, bye-bye. Thank you.